My name is Katie Legan, and I'm a PM intern here at Microsoft. In this video, I will walk through how to use the Postman service to make an API request to the Intelligent Recommendation Service. Before we begin, please make sure that you have watched the Quick Start Guide setup video to make an Intelligent Recommendations account with a service endpoint, which we will use to serve the API requests. Also, be sure to download the Postman REST API tool from the internet. Once you have an IR account and have downloaded Postman, we will need to first determine which Azure Active Directory application to call the service endpoint from. To do this, navigate to the Azure portal. Open Azure Active Directory and click on App Registrations. Then click New Registration to create a new application. To make the new application, create a name for the app and then click Register. Once the application is created, you will see the application client ID and the directory tenant ID. You will need this information later to authenticate the API request. Next, we will need to update your service endpoint's permissions to allow the new application to use this endpoint. To do this, navigate to the Azure portal. Click on your Intelligent Recommendations account. On the left menu, click Endpoint Authentications. You can then add your application as an authorized user by pasting in your application ID we found earlier into the Principal ID field, and then add the directory tenant ID from earlier into the AAD tenant ID field. Change the principal type to application and then click Save. Now we need to configure the authentication by creating either a secret or a certificate. In this video, we will demonstrate how to create a secret. To do this, return to your newly created application page in the Azure Active Directory. Click on Certificates and Secrets. Then click Create New Secret. Save the value of this secret, as this will be used to call the API request. Now we are ready to make the API request. Start by opening up the Postman app on your computer. Before you make the request, we will need to fill out some information to authenticate the request. First, click Create a Request and navigate to the Authorization tab. On the left side, change the type to Auth 2.0 and keep Add Authorization Data on Request headers. In the Get Request section at the top, you will put the request URL. We provide a list of sample request URLs that can be found on our Docs page. To find these URLs, navigate to the Intelligent Recommendations Docs page and click on Sample API Requests from the left menu. You will see several examples of the different requests that you can call. For this video, we will use the popular list request as an example. Returning to the Postman app, paste in the URL. On the right side, you will create a name for your token. The grant type should be changed to client credentials. Most of the rest of the needed information can be copied from our docs on the Make an Authenticated API Call page. To find this, click on the dropdown under Quick Start and then Make an Authenticated API Call. And scroll down to the Calling the Endpoint with Postman section. The access token URL is found here. Note that you will have to input the caller tenant ID that we copied earlier. You can find this by returning to your application, clicking on Overview, and copying this tenant ID field. You will then paste in the access token URL. Next, we will find the client ID. Returning to Postman, the client ID is the application ID we copied earlier. You can find this by returning to the application page and copying this application ID. Return to the Postman app and paste in the client ID. Next, we will paste in the client secret. The client secret is the value of the client secret that we copied earlier. You can find this by returning to your application, clicking on Certificates and Secrets, and copying this value. Paste in the client secret. Finally, the scope can be copied from the docs page as it is always the same value. Keep the client authentication as send as basic auth header. Once the information is filled out, click Get New Access Token. And then click Use Token. Then you are ready to send the request. Hit Send at the top of the page. If everything was set up correctly, the response will appear in the bottom console under the Body tab. The Items field will return a ranked of list items. In this example, the most popular item is this top item here. If you run into any errors with the service, please go to our troubleshooting page or support page to contact our team directly. Thank you for watching, and be sure to check out the rest of the videos in the series to learn more about intelligent recommendations.